These are the people who continue to fear Allah. They continue to fear their master. They're worried, no matter how much I did, how many mistakes did I have, and even the good things I did. Forget the bad things, that's bad enough. Even the good things we do are full of mistakes. Even the good things we do. So they're afraid, is this even acceptable with Allah or not? And on top of that, وَيَخَافُونَ سُوءَ الْحِسَابِ. They're afraid of the worst type of audit. And I'm using the word hisab instead of accountability. I'm using the word audit here. And it's important to understand, on the Day of Judgment, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warns, إِنَّهُ مَنْ سُئِلَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَقَدْ هَلَكَ. Whoever gets asked even once has been destroyed. If your interrogation begins, if one question gets asked, you're done. When you and I are losing our patience, maybe we haven't found the right motivation to be patient yet. These ayahs are offering that motivation. وَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنْفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً. And they establish the prayer, and they spend from what we have given them secretly and openly. And then he says, وَيَبْرَأُونَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ السَّيِّئَةِ. Such an awesome statement, and so easy to say, so easy to remember, but so hard to live by. Wallahi, so hard to live by. He says they repel every bad thing that happens to them with something good. Bad stuff happens to us all the time. Things that test our patience happen to us all the time. These people that Allah is praising in this passage, Allah says their quality is, when something bad happens, their immediate reaction is they do something good. They do something good, and they heard some really nasty language, they say kind words in response. Something really horrible happened at work, they pray two extra rak'ah. They do a good deed in response to a bad one. It's an incredible thing. You know, when somebody says something bad to you, what's your almost always reaction? You said two things to me? Let me tell you, my arsenal, I am far more equipped than you are. They do pop pop, you do prrrr, you know. that's what it is. This is not yadra'una, you know, hasana bisayya. On the other hand, a sayya could also mean here, whenever they do a sin, immediately they nullify that sin by doing something good. You know what most people do when they do a sin? Oh, I'm so messed up. Might as well be a little more messed up. You know, like, you just spiral downward. You just, I'm in a rut already, might as well, you know, go as far as I can take this. Right? But this is not the quality of these people. But this is my favorite part of this ayah. وَالَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا إِبْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِمْ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ. And those who remained patient in pursuit of the face of their master. You know what that means? All of us, in some point in life, we go through a hard time and we're supposed to be patient. All of us, there's no exception. Whether your test of patience comes to you from your wife, or your husband, or your parents, or your children, or your job, or your friends, or all of them at the same time, the ayah I want to share with you is the next one and I'll be done. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, جَنَّاتُ عَدْنٍ يَدْخُلُونَهَا اللَّهُمَّ اجْعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ. These are the gardens of Adn. You know, in English they say gardens of Eden. You've heard that before? One of the levels of Jannah is called Adn. One of the higher levels of Jannah. These are the levels of Adn that they're entering. يَدْخُلُونَهَا. They're entering into these amazing gardens.